Some people are saying photography's dead because of AI. Hold my coffee. I'm going to show you how to use Generative Fill to combine your own photos. So let's combine them. Click and drag into the tab. Hold down the Shift key to center it and then release. Now we've got both of these in one document. Let's resize this. Control or Command T for free transform. Now we want to do this proportionally from the middle. So hold down the Alt or the Option key and drag in one of the corners. And then we can drag this out to the size that we want. Okay, so there's a technique to get this to actually blend into the image, and I'll show you right now. So the first thing we want to do is just grab our quick selection, and I want to select the main part of the building. So we've selected the building, but what we want to do is just select the border between the building and the outside. So we're just going to choose Command-Shift-I to inverse, or just choose Select Inverse. So notice the marching ants on the outside. Everything is selected except for our building. But we don't want to select the whole background. We just want to select just a little border around there. So grab the rectangular marquee tool, hold down the Alt or the Option key for the minus, and then drag. Remember to leave a little bit of edge around there. Let's grab the second edge. Excellent. Let me just grab a brush so you can see where selected. Notice that we've just selected that area. Perfect. So let's use Generative Fill to blend this in. So we're going to click Generative Fill. Leave it blank so it uses the surroundings, and then click Generate. Now, it's important to have that border. If you don't have that border around there, it won't work. And look at that. There's the first option. Let's look at the other two. Second variation, third variation. Interesting. I think I'm going to go with the first variation. And just for fun, let's add a waterfall here. So let's just click and drag down. Hit Generative Fill and type in waterfall. Isn't that amazing? And if you're getting any value out of this video, hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my videos. Let's do a completely different example, which is actually a lesson off my brand new course on Generative Fill. Let's take the forest and we're going to drag it into the ocean, hold down the Shift key to center it. Let's zoom out a little bit. Now drag down until we're actually off the canvas. Perfect. You probably think I'm going to go for the crop tool, but I'm not. I'm going to use Image, Reveal All, and that shows the entire canvas. Now let's grab our rectangular tool. So watch Generative Fill actually create a whole new area to blend these together in a realistic way. So let's make a selection over part of the beach, part of the forest, with lots of overlap. And then just hit Generate. And look at the three options. Second option, third option. So as you can see here, you can use Generative Fill with your own photographs. Drop a comment underneath and let me know your thoughts. I've got a new course on Generative Fill. I'll drop a link underneath. If you guys enjoyed this, hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications. So one of the challenges can be resolution. I've got a little hack for that. Check out the video right there that I've made. Thanks for watching. Until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.